अमया,
प्रसन्न
अतुल्या,
प्रसन्न
दृश्या,
मिस
ज्योतिष, ज्योतिष,
प्रसन्न मिस प्रसन्न
कार्तिक,
मिस
या कार्तिक,
प्रसन्न मिस
काव्या,
प्रसन्न
अचिकेतस,
प्रसन्न
नीरज, रंगीत, वैष्णव, ओके,
प्रसन्न
वैष्णव, अंजलि, श्रुति, या ओके, श्रुति, श्रुति इज नॉट
इसे श्रोते के
ओके.
पानी आ
सो लास्ट क्लास व्हाट वी वर डिस्कसिंग और मैं एंडा आर्किंग लव दा पढ़ी चंडी टुडे
सिक्योरिटी
सिक्योरिटी
सोशल टीम सॉकेट लायर डीएलएस
वन सेकेंड ओके वी वर डीलिंग विथ द सिक्योरिटी एट द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर एंड ऑल्सो आई हैव जस्ट टोल्ड सम लिटिल बिट पार्ट अबाउट द सिक्योरिटी एट द नेटवर्क लेयर नाउ व्हाट आर द टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोटोकॉल्स दैट यू आर यूजिंग फॉर द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ सिक्योरिटी एट द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर नचिकेतस व्हाट आर द टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोटोकॉल्स दैट यू आर मेकिंग यूज ऑफ इन द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर Security protocols, I'm asking.
हेलो
Yeah, tell.
एसएसएल टीएलएस
SSL and TLS,
टीएलएस
right? SSL is nothing. What is the expansion of SSL? The SSL is going to mean it is secure,
सिक्योर सॉकेट लेयर
socket layer, and also TLS is. Transport layer security and I have told you you have to just compare these two protocols how many of you have done it Amaya did you complete it comparison of TLS and SSL protocol
Yes, Miss. Text blocking.
Idea
Ah.
others what about Adulya അതുല്യ എഴുതിയോ ഇല്ല ദെൻ അജ്മീന ആൻഡ് അമയ അഫ്ല എഴുതിയോ
Yes, Miss.
യെസ് ഓക്കെ റൈറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ടുഡേ വി വിൽ ബി ജസ്റ്റ് ഡീലിംഗ് വിത്ത് ദ സെക്യൂരിറ്റി അറ്റ് ദി നെറ്റ്വർക്ക് ലെയർ നെറ്റ്വർക്ക് ലെയർ ഐ ഹാവ് ടോൾഡ് യു that protocol is called it as the IPSec, IP security protocol. And you have at it actually this IPsec protocol is nothing but they are collection of protocols right now what is the importance of this IPsec is you are providing security in the network layer and two things are satisfied by this IPsec protocol one is authentication and another one is the confidential packets can be created for the IP layer And I have told you some key functions of this IPsec protocol. One is confidentiality, data integrity, authentication, and anti-replay. Confidentiality means you are encrypting your data. Integrity means the data has not been changed. Authentication means you are authenticating your receiver. And anti-replay means the packet is unique. It has not been getting duplicated or intercepted. So these are some of the services or functions of provided by the IPsec protocol. Now today we will be just seeing about the two different modes of this IPsec protocol. Very, very important. Usually it will be asked what are the different modes of operation. Now the first mode is called it as the transport mode. Now all of you listen here. The first mode is called it as the transport mode. Now this transport mode actually in this transport mode this IPsec protects what is delivered from the transport layer. You know you are dealing with the network layer. Now, whatever is receiving from the transport layer, and that is getting protected by this protocol, right? So the meaning is you have the data here. Transport layer payload means transport layer data you are having. In between the transport layer and the network layer, you have the IPsec layer. So once the data is transferred from this transport layer towards the network layer, IPsec layer comes into action. And what they will do is they will provide security to the data that is obtained from the transport layer. And that is added in the form of header and trailer. Now, actually, this data will be called it as the IP payload, the whole thing. Your headers and trailers that is provided from the IPsec layer, and also the data that is coming from the transport layer. So all these things together, you are calling it as IP payload or IP data packet. Okay, now in addition to that, you are adding one IP header also. Once the packet reaches the network layer, you are adding additional header field. But when you are in the transport mode, this IPsec is not protecting this header part. It is protecting only what it is being delivered from the transport layer. Okay, so that is the main concept of this transport mode. You are not protecting, it does not protect the IP header. It is only protecting the information coming from the transport. Understanding IPsec in transport mode protects what is delivered from the transport layer. You know, transport layer down is the network layer. So data will be passed at the sender side. The data will be forwarded from the transport layer to the network layer. And in between that, you are having the IPsec layer. So the data that is coming from the transport layer will be protected by the IPsec protocols. And that is added, and how they are doing is they are adding some information with this, and that information will be in the form of headers and trailers, and that will be passed to the network layer, right? So it is not protecting the IP header. It does not protect the whole IP packet. It is only protecting the data or the packet that is coming from the transport layer. Understanding? Now, this transport layer, usually where it will be used is, it is mainly used in host-to-host communication or end-to-end protection of data. If you want to protect your data between two hosts or between end-to-end protection, you are making use of this transport mode. Now, here you have two hosts, host A and B. This is the sender part and this is the receiver part. So, the sending host, they make use of this IPsec to authenticate and encrypt the payload, what is delivered from the transport layer. Payload means data, right? So sender side, when you are considering this IPsec, what it will do is, it is mainly, it is used to provide authentication and encryption of the data that is delivered from the transport layer. Right now, at the receiver side, this host, receiving host, they make use of this IPsec protocol or security services in order to check the authentication and decrypt the IP packet, and that will be delivered to the transport layer. Right, so the receiver side, once the data reaches the network layer, it will be forwarded towards the transport layer. Right here it is from the transport layer, the data is obtaining and you are transferring into the network layer. So transport mode, it is usually used when you need host to host protection of data. At the sender side, you are authenticating as well as encrypting the payload that is delivered from the transport layer. Now at the receiver side, you are checking the authentication. It is used to check the authentication and for decrypting the IP packet. Right, and that will be delivered to the transport layer. Understood what is transport mode in IPsec protocol? Yes or no?
Yes, miss.
Yes, okay. So just remember, transport mode is in action between two hosts. Right, now the other type of mode is called, the second type of mode is called it as the tunnel mode. Now in tunnel mode, this IPsec protects the entire IP packet. Now what it will do is it will takes the IP packet. Now you have the network layer, you have your IP payload plus your IP header. So what in tunnel mode, the whole data will be protected, right? It takes the IP packet, including the header. They will provide it or applies the IP security methods in the form of headers and trailers. And this whole entire packet will be added to the new network layer. You have actually, it is between, you imagine you'll have two network layers. So once the data is received from the transport layer, headers will be added in that. And this header plus the IP payload is being applied with IP services, IPsec services. And that is in the form of headers and trailers. And that is actually passed towards your network layer. And that is known as the new IP payload. Now, with respect to that new IP payload, you are adding again a new header. So tunnel mode is taking place between network layer and network layer. Imagine you are having only one network layer, but actually what is happening is like this. Okay, so what in tunnel mode, what is happening is you are protecting the original IP header. There is differences between these headers. This new header and the old header, what is attached with this, you are having some differences between this. Okay, so this tunnel mode, what it is doing is, this is protecting the entire IP packet. Entire IP packet means you are having the payload as well as the header field. And the services is added in the form of headers and trailers. And that will be passed to your new network layer. And that will be your new IP payload. And some new IP header also will be attached along with that. Right? Now, tunnel mode is normally used between two routers. You have router A and router B. So usually it will be used between two routers, or it can be a host and a router, or it can be a router and a host. These are the possibilities. It cannot be two hosts. Okay, so the tunnel mode, usually it operates between two routers, or a host and a router, or a router and a host, and not between two hosts. Between two hosts, the transport mode comes into action. Right. Now, the entire original packet, it will be protected from intrusion between the sender and the receiver. And you are imagining that the whole IP packet is going in the form of, through an imaginary tunnel. Right? So in a summary, I can tell that this IPsec in tunnel mode, it is protecting the original IP header. Okay? So just remember the two different modes of IPsec protocol. One is the transport mode, the other one is the tunnel mode. Now, how you can compare these two modes? This is transport mode versus tunnel mode. I have told you, you have application layer, you have transport layer, and you have network layer. In between these two layers, you have the IPsec layer in the transport mode. But in tunnel mode, it is between two. You have two network layers, and in between that, your tunnel mode is coming into action. Right? So in transport mode, the IPsec layer comes between the transport layer and the network layer. And in tunnel mode, the flow is from the network layer to the IPsec layer and then back to the network layer again. Right? So that is the difference between transport mode and tunnel mode. So once it is asked, you should be able to write it or represent it with the help of a diagram. Very, very important. Usually it will be asked, what are the different modes of operation in this IPsec? Understood? Two different modes, transport mode and tunnel mode. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Now, next, what you are going to see is about the protocols. especially what are the two different types of protocols in this IPsec, relating with the IPsec services. So the first type of protocol is called it as the AH protocol. This is also very, very important. Usually it will be asked. So AH protocol. AH means authentication header. This is the first type of protocol. Now the second type of protocol is called it as ESP. ESP means encapsulating security payload. I repeat, encapsulating security payload. So these are the two different types of protocols. Now, actually, for what purpose is this protocols? This is to provide authentication and encryption for the packets at the IP level, right? You want to provide authentication as well as encryption. Now, this AH protocol, it is designed to authenticate the source host. And also, it has to ensure the integrity of the payload carried in the IP packet. I repeat, this authentication header is designed to authenticate the source host, right? And also you have to ensure the integrity of the data. And that is carried in your IP packet, right? Now, in order to do that, in order to provide authentication and integrity, you are making use of hash function and a symmetric key. So in order to have authentication and this integrity, what you are doing is the protocol uses a hash function and a symmetric key to create a message digest or to create the authentication data. And this digest or this data is inserted in the authentication header. And that will be placed in appropriate location based on the mode. If we are using transport mode, it will be located according to that. It will be operating according to the tunnel mode. It will work according to which mode you are using, whether it is transport mode or whether it is tunnel mode. Okay, so the first type of IPsec protocol is authentication header protocol, and mainly it is designed to provide authentication and integrity of the authenticating the source host, right? And you have authentication, the source host means you want to ensure that your data has come from the valid user, valid sender. And also you have to ensure the integrity of the data. So in order to do that, two things you are using. One is the hash function and other one is the symmetric key. And they are used to create the authentication data. And that data you can call it as digest. Right, and that will be inserted in your authentication header. Now you have got different fields of this authentication header. Like you just understand what are the different fields. Like you have next header, you have payload length, you have whatever is received data, reserved data. Then you have the security parameter index, you have the sequence number, and finally the authentication data. These are the different fields, how we will be studying about the different frame formats like that. The authentication header has different fields, right? Now, the first field is what I told is the next header field. It is usually of 8 bits. And what it defines is, it defines the type of payload carried by the IP datagram. IP datagram is nothing but the IP packet. Payload is nothing but the data. So it is defining what type of data you are carrying by the IP datagram, right? So that is will be represented in the next header. Now next you have the payload length. Payload length means it is not defining actually the length of the data, but it is defining the length of the authentication header. What is the total length of the authentication header that will be displayed here? Now you have security, this is for reserved for some purpose, and you have the security parameter index, right? And you have the sequence number. Sequence number, you know, it is mainly used for ordering information, right? Now, finally, you have the authentication data. And this authentication data is nothing but it is the result that has been obtained by applying the hash function and the symmetric key. Now, what is the main thing related with authentication data is it is ensuring authentication and integrity. It is ensuring this authentication header protocol, it is ensuring the authentication and data integrity. These are the two things that has been provided from this authentication header, but it is not dealing with the privacy. Privacy is not there when you are making use of this authentication header protocol, right? So this is about the first type of protocol, IPsec protocol, that is the authentication header. Authentication header protocol, it is mainly designed to authenticate the source host and also to ensure the integrity of the payload that is carried in the IP packet. Authentication is provided as well as this integrity, it is provided with the help of hash function and symmetric key, and this is being placed in the header field. You have different fields, and here the authentication data that will be carried actually towards the header part, right? So main thing, it is providing source authentication and integrity, but it is not providing privacy. This is the first type of protocol. Now the second type is called it as ESP protocol. ESP means encapsulating security payload. Now, what is the speciality of this is, this is providing actually source authentication is there, integrity is there, and privacy is also provided, right? So you have authentication done here, you have integrity, data integrity done here, and also privacy is also provided here. Now, ESP, what it does is it adds its header and trailer along with the data. You have IP header, you just imagine I have told about the IP header and the remaining is known as the IP packet, right? Now these are the different fields when you are considering the ESP protocol, right? So this will be adding its header field as well as the trailer field, right? Now one, actually this is added at the one at the end of the packet and one at the beginning of the packet. Now you have certain procedures to ensure, to provide the security of the data. First one is, that is what I just told, trailer is added to the payload. Trailer is added along with the data. Now, this payload and the trailer, they are encrypted nextly. So the rest of, you have the data payload here, you have the trailer part here, and both will get encrypted, right? Now, the ESP header will be attached to it. Now the ESP header, payload, and the trailer are used to create the authenticated data. Now this authentication data are added to the end of the ESP trailer. Now whatever is obtained after this step, that will be added along with this end of the data, right? End of the ESP trailer. After this trailer, you are adding the authentication data. So the IP header is added after the protocol value. Once it is fixed, you are adding the IP header part. Okay, so ESP procedure, you have some procedure how to do that, how to provide this authentication, data integrity, and privacy. So initially, the trailer is added, then the payload is added along with the trailer to have encryption. Then this is header is added, so you will be getting the authenticated data and that will be attached to the end of the trailer, right? And again, last, the IP header will be added. Now here also, this ESP header and trailer, you have got different fields. You have security parameter index. It is not actually that from the textbook what I have taken, it is not clear there also. So you just understand that this field is security parameter index and this is the sequence number. Now what I have told in AH protocol, the same thing is happening. Sequence number for ordering, you have some parameter index here. So the same thing is functioning is in the case of ESP protocol also, right? Now the trailer field, they have some different fields like padding, then pad length, next header field, etc. right? So usually some bytes are used. If it is not according to the byte, you will be adding zeros along with that. And padlang means how many bytes you have padded it, that will be defined here. And next header is now what I have told with AH protocol, that is remaining the same. Right, now the authentication data, it is the result of applying an authentication scheme to the parts of the datagram. Okay, understood. What are the two different types of protocol? Just remember that you have to just draw the diagram and explain it. Ensure AH protocol, privacy is not provided, but authentication and integrity is being there. But in ESP, all three are provided. Source authentication, integrity, and privacy. Okay. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes.
Right? So what I had told up to now is related with the security at the network layer. You have studied the two different protocols. One is AH protocol and another one is the ESP protocol. And also I have told about two different modes of operation. One is the tunnel mode and another one is the transport. Right? Now, you have to know what is the application of this IPsec. This I'll just telling the concept only. You have to refer text for the additional details. Okay? So this is the application of IPsec. So I'm just telling about a virtual private network, where the security is being provided, that is nothing but it is a virtual private network. Now what is the meaning of virtual? Virtual means it is not physically existing, but appear to exist physically, right? Now, a virtual computer is not a physical machine. Now, you are not able to, it is not able to, you won't be able to touch it or feel it like as we do in our systems, which is inbuilt in our PC. But what is actually it is like a computer. It is also capable of performing tasks just like a real physical computer. Right. Now, here I have to shown two different diagrams. This is a local area network. You know what is a local area network. Now, what is a local area network? It is a private network that interconnects computers or any other devices within a limited geographic area. Like what you have in your home, your campus, your office, etc. So you are having a private network where all the devices are connected. Right? So that is a local area network. But this virtual private network is like LAN only, but what is the major difference between VPN and LAN is that the devices that are part of the LAN, they could be anywhere. They are not limited to a specific geographic area. They can be spread across the world. It could be anywhere. Okay. Now, they are connected to each other, not through a private network, but over a public network or the internet. Understanding? A LAN is nothing but you are limited to a specific geographic area, but VPN is not limited to a specific geographic area. The devices are spread across. It could be anywhere, right? Now, how they are connected is not through a private network, but it is over a public network or the internet, right? Now, this VPN, actually, it uses a process called tunneling. I have told you, a tunnel channel, communication channel will be created. So it uses a technology called tunneling. Tunneling means a virtual point-to-point connection. That is called it as that tunneling means. So the tunneling creates a secured, encrypted connection between your computer and the other devices within the same virtual private network. Now, what is the meaning is, imagine this is your company network. this is which is secret, but you are somewhere in your house or away from your private network. So making a VPN connection, this you can act as if you belong to that network. Okay, so by the process of tunneling, you are creating a secured encrypted connection between your computer and the other devices within the virtual private network, right? You are making a virtual connection along with the private network, but actually you are not present in that network, you are away from that network, right? Now with a virtual private network, any employee, they can access his own private corporate network when they are away from their house they are at home or they are at some outside of their private network, and that also will be in a secure fashion, right? So the internet connection over the VPN is encrypted and secure. Now IPsec VPN establish VPN connection over IPsec encryption protocols. You are making use of the IP security protocols in order to establish a VPN connection, and mainly that is you have simply virtual network, local area network is there, you have IPsec VPN also. So IPsec VPN means you are making use of this IP security protocols to create a virtual connection, right? So VPN is a mechanism for employing, encryption is there, authentication is there, integrity is there, so that you can use your network anywhere. Okay, so this perimeter network and all I will just tell later. You just assume a VPN connection can be made, which is very secure, right? So this is one of the applications of this IPsec. Sometimes it will be asked, list any application of this IP security, or write a short note on virtual private network. So you should be able to write it. Okay, so these are the things that I need to tell in today's class. Fifth hour, we will be continuing with the other topics. So what I have told, I'll give a summary what we have explained now. So I have started with the IP security at the network layer. You have gone with the two different modes of operation. One is called it as the transport mode, and another one is called it as the tunnel mode. So transport mode, it is mainly for authentication and integrity, but it is not providing any privacy to that data. Now, usually transport mode is used to protect the data that is coming from the transport layer. It is not protecting the IP header that is added in the network layer. Hope you are understanding. IPsec in transport mode, it is not protecting the IP header, but it is protecting the information what is coming from the transport layer. Okay, now this transport mode is usually used when you need a host-to-host protection of data, or end-to-end protection of data. So the sending host, they make use of this IPsec services to authenticate and encrypt the data, what is coming from or what is delivered from the transport layer. Now the receiver, they will make use to decrypt it, right? Now the other mode, what I told is the tunnel mode. Tunnel mode, here you are having authentication, encryption, as well as privacy. Tunnel mode, how it has been happening is you are protecting the entire IP packet there. That is, you are assume it has two network layers, right? So the it is actually protecting the original IP header. What is coming from the transfer, what is added in the network layer. And additional to that, a new IP header will be added along with the data, so that the new IP header what you have added and the original IP header both are having different information. So you are protecting your IP header, original IP header, you are protecting in the tunnel mode, right? Now After that, I told about the two security protocols. One is the authentication header protocol, and another one is the encapsulating security protocol. You have to just remember what is the frame format of this AH protocol as well as the ESP protocol. And you have got different fields in both the things. You have to just write what are the different, what does each field indicate, right? Now, I have also told about one of the application of this IPsec, that is IPsec VPN. IPsec VPN is used to establish VPN connection over IPsec encryption protocols. Your VPN is offering a high amount of security. You can remotely access a private network. That is the importance of virtual private. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, miss.
Yes. Okay. Other class, Atulya can present it. Okay. In the fifth hour, I will take one more topic and you can also present. And Vaishnav, you can also present it because last day it was connection was disrupted. So you can also present it today. Now, once you present it, you can upload it in Linways and also send a copy to me, okay? So that I can forward, so that everyone can visualize that. Right? Now, the remaining topics, okay. Parallelly, you just...